guys, this is second day in Isle of Skye, second or third now, I'm lost account. We lost one day in a storm. We had to really evacuate from top of the hill, but we ended up having a nice and safe place for the night. And today we woke up at Portree. There's a harbour behind me. And beautiful mountains that way. I'm gonna extend you so you can see better. And today we're gonna be spending maybe half a day at Portree. I'll show you the port, I'll show you the harbour. It's nice, it's supposed to be nice weather. You can hear the seagulls. The fish and chips shops are under the siege. Basically, everybody's ordering fish and chips. And do not feed the seagulls, written everywhere. So this is me at Portree. At the end of the pier, I found just hooked. And I'm going in to see what's available. This is fresh fish. This is not cooked. Oh, it's dark. Okay. Oh, everything looks nice. Wow. Oysters, Ian. Oyster, £1 each for oysters. £1 each for oysters. What would you like? Would you like something? Looks fresh. There's a haddock, there's a cod, trout. Trout is bony. Haddock costs the same as salmon. The shop is spotless. It's such a shame nobody here. Everybody's at the beginning of the pier. And we're gonna get some fish. We got two pieces of lovely haddock here. That's quite a way to it for £8. So that will probably be two dinners for us. That's £4 for dinner, that's £2 per person for dinner. And that will be freshly cooked in a fresh oil, not from fish and chip shop, lard or anything like this. It will be cooked in vegetable oil, freshly by me, moi, or Ian, because he just told me recently this morning that he can cook.
The fishing boat comes in every night.
Yes, the lady, lovely lady inside the shop. The shop is called again, Just Hooked, right at the end of the pier. She said that the fish comes every night. They clean it and cut it over the night and freshly for sale in the morning. Brilliant. Everything looks, the shop was spotless. Absolutely spotless. And you know how the fish shop can be smelly? There is no smell because it's too fresh to have any kind of smell. Did you notice, Ian? There was no smell in the shop.
No.
It was just fresh, fresh, fresh. And the shop was literally, literally spotless. So well done, Portree. I'm sorry I'm not gonna buy any fish and chips from any of those little shops at the harbour, but I prefer my own cooked fish at home. And now we're gonna have to look for some maybe coffee shop.
Fancy coffee? Yes.
Yeah. So we are happy, we have our dinner. We don't know where we're gonna stay tonight. Last night we spent at the campsite because we needed a washing machine. Yes, Mitzi did it. You know, I think Queenie was stressed out and she had a little accident on a bedding. But everything is sorted now. Everything is clean, washed, dried.
Here comes the rain.
And here comes the rain. Here comes the rain, so I put sunglasses off. It's a little drizzle. But it's nice, it's warm. Guys, look. Can you see my legs? I'm just wearing a skirt and flip-flops, and Ian is wrapped like for winter. But it's actually quite mild. I wish there was less bins in here on the pier, but I guess with all the businesses here and probably normal shops as well, they need the bins. It's like walking around bins. Okay, let's see what I can get, take from here. Something I have never seen before. We are just on the way to the harbour, that way. And there's a little craft shop here. And the only thing I see is dead flies. There is one, two, three, four. There's also a dead wasp. And there's a dead wasp over there. Guys, this is not nice. don't have dead flies and dead wasps all over the display. These are crafters. This is your life food, yeah? This is what you do for a living. Then get it right. How long it takes to clean a windowsill? Less than a minute. Nobody even goes to those windowsills forever. The windows are dirty and covered in dead bugs. Come on. Not right. Especially in a touristy place like Portree, when you have a lot of foreigners coming in. And don't let them see this. The roads are very busy in here. We had problem to even cross. There were two minibuses stuck and we were just standing there. We couldn't cross the road. And you know what? The driver of the minibus was a very young girl. And everybody gave her a thumb up at the end because she did manage that maneuver. Well done, girl. And let's see what else Portree has to offer. Beautiful scarves with brooches. Portree knitwear. Looks made in China to me, but who am I to say? Full breakfast, $9.85 at the cafe. $9.85 for breakfast? Oh, there is a square, Ian. I think, guys, you're getting too... I need to grab the mic because we are in a windy square. Oh, there is a something for pro-independence. I think either they getting signatures or they're just telling people to vote for independence. Big enough, smart enough, rich enough, Scotland, independence. I'll show you because I want you to see this. I mean, okay, you're big, not big, but you're smart and you're rich. Have a look. Vote yes. I would, if I could. S&P. It's quite hectic in here. Let's see what we have. Britain, Great Brexit, Britain and independence. Oh, you can buy a fridge magnet. Something like that. You can buy flags for £5, t-shirts for £10. Donations welcome. This is S&P. No, this is S&P. Well, I'm not gonna be political in here. I don't get involved. But I don't see them being overwhelmed, or any of them being overwhelmed with people. I think, you know, this is a touristy place. There's a lot of Asians and Americans. They can't really get involved in this. They wouldn't know what it is. They wouldn't understand. We just want to sit down for coffee. Ian, do you see any place to sit down? They have a table outside. Okay, I see a table outside. And this is, this looks like a war monument. This is for the Great War, 1914-1919, not Second World War. Oh, this is for the Second World War too. So we are at the main square. I think this is like a main central square. Sorry if it's windy. And we are going to the place called the Granary, just here. it says coffee shop. And we want coffee outside.
I'm going to go to the cash machine to have a fish.
Okay. I'm sure they take cards. Everywhere you go here, they want cash. The fish shop, cash only. Campsite, cash only. So there's a Bank of Scotland next door. Ian went just in case they're gonna tell us they don't take cards. We will be ready with cash. We're gonna give you a review in a minute. Ian ordered cappuccino and mayonnaise shortbread. Looks scrumptious. No, have a lick. That's all I can afford. Ian took all the chocolate
in
the cappuccino thinking, why
might
not like it? Guys, this is the noisiest. I don't know if you can hear me. This is the noisiest coffee shop I have ever sat on. There's a bus after bus after bus after bus.
It doesn't feel like an island. It's too much traffic.
It's bonkers. I know this is the capital of Sky, but it's just now there's a school out. School is out, or some kind of children queuing up next door. I don't know.
It's lunchtime.
Lunchtime for school. The children are queuing for fish and chips or whatever is next door, and there's literally bus after bus after bus on the square passing by. I'm crazy like it. We just want to have coffee and we want to get out of here because it's too noisy. And we left our cats on a very, very busy road as well, so they will not be happy there. And it's time, it's already 2 o'clock, but it's only 2 o'clock, and I'm thinking already of finding a place to sleep for tonight. So, Ian Amti. You see what I mean? One bus after another. You can hear the rocket behind me. No, thanks. Chocolate, thank you. Okay guys, let's see where we're gonna be next. I'm sorry to tell you, I just tried this cappuccino. It's just too bitter. It's like espresso with a bit of milk. No. No good granary. No good. Like shortbread, okay. Coffee, no. We decided to leave lovely Portree. It's just too much traffic for us. In Portree, as you see, one car after another. Even where, as I speak. So this is the last view. And we have to go and attend our babies. I'm afraid we don't like to leave them alone for too long because they can, you know, they can cause damage or to themselves or the car. They're probably asleep, knowing cats. Yes, you can see there's already a car park. We were lucky to have the space to park. We are just outside the town. Here's our car. You see two camper vans behind us. It's time to see what they're up to. Let's see what our cats are up to. Let's catch them by surprise and see what they're doing. Are they on the front seat? That is one. Let's see, where's another one? Oh, you can't see because I closed the window.
You can see through.
Okay, let's go.